Minister within the Ministry of Housing and Water met with residents of Fort Ardnance earlier today. Details in this report.
The Minister within the Ministry of Housing and Water, Ms. Suzanne Rodrigues, visited the residents of Fort Ardnance today, September 24, 2021, for a community meeting where several matters were highlighted and she revealed the Ministry's planned projects for the remainder of the year. During her brief remarks, Minister Rodrigues noted,
"We are aware that there is a backlog of house lot applications in this region, and so we are also in the process of identifying new areas, and we have ongoing right now works that were in the 2021 budget, works that are ongoing in Fortland Ardnance to the tune of $150 million. And these are new in development works, new infrastructure works in those areas. We also have development works in excess of $200 million in Hampshire and Williamsburg, and in excess of $250 million in number 75 and 79 villages. And all of these works are on schedule to be completed before December 2021, or by this year end."
Additionally, she shared proposed plans for 2022.
We already have two water treatment plants on the coast, and we are going to build a third one in 2022, which will cover the entire quarantine coast, so that all those people who live along the coast will have access to treated water.
Several individuals took the time to make appeals to the ministry about house lot allocations and house lot application issues.
I have 6 years now, and I really love to have one house lot. I went in back and I called it and I updated, but no one said anything.
When you updated?
This year, January. Yes.
All right. So we have it listed?
Yes.
This up?
Yeah, I have my
apartment before. Okay. Where are you before?
I asked for Region 6 for the Fort Ardnance because I'm already living in the scheme.
So I just need the amendment. Somebody is living on my lot, which I'm having a transport for. I supposed to be on 140, but I drop on 115. And when I do a survey, then I know that the person is on my lot.
So you are willing to accept 115?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just the amendment to be done.
That has to be sent to the court.
My major issue is, and the house application that I've made sometime back that hasn't addressed as yet. So here I am today to see if it could be addressed.
Other individuals highlighted challenges about overpriced utility bills.
For a whole of last year, I didn't pay my water bill because it says pandemic, and then they don't disconnect the water, so I just left it like that. Now the bill comes $75,000. Now they sent a bill here yesterday, The bill is $20,000 for a month.
All right. Because we said we wouldn't disconnect people, didn't mean that you don't have to pay for your water. You still have to pay for your water.
I know.
We'll ask the regional manager to just take your information. We'll visit your home, make sure that the readings are correct, and we'll try to put you on a payment plan that you can afford.
Tell me that you say you could get on to me concerning the reason that you like bill. And up to now, nobody, nothing. I may try to meet somebody concerned. We got some evidence, how the bill raised. If you need to see it, make them.
That's a GPS?
GPS.
Give this young lady your name and your telephone number. I'll have someone from GPS visit you and just to make sure.
I'm just trying to know for this water bill. It comes $78,000.
The
water bill?
Yeah.
One resident even appealed for better roads in Fort Ardnance.
Which people would say is the back of the scheme. That road is in a deploring state. And the rain is coming again. When the taxi drop you the $1,000, they put you out with your bag and all your goods. Then they won't go in that back there. So I'm speaking on behalf of the residents. I'm pleading if we could get some, we call it a crusher nail or whatever stuff. Right. And we would come together as a resident and spread it out. I wish if you guys can go down.
If you have to go to the next meeting, I have already spoken.
I can take you, I ride my bicycle and you can.
Yes.
Further, Minister Rodrigues committed to providing 10 streetlights for the area. From Fort Ordnance, the minister, along with her team and the regional officials, made their way to Chesney, Babujan, and Ankerville, where similar meetings were held. Narima Ali, Channel 8 News.